Empirical probability versus empirical likelihood. This video describes the most important differences between two ways of calculating a ratio. These ratios are useful for a variety of calculations, one of which is land change modeling. First, we will explain the theory behind these two calculations. Then we will demonstrate their differences by giving examples using TerrSet, a land change modeling program made by Clark Labs. Consider this example. Envision these squares as different layers of a study area. The map on the left is divided into presence and absence of a feature, in this case built and non-built, and the map on the right contains an explanatory categorical variable, in this case soil types A and B. Empirical probability and empirical likelihood are two measures of the association between the features in the left map and the categories on the right map. Probability computes the proportion of a given category that is built. For example, the probability that soil A is built is calculated using the equation size of intersection of soil A and built divided by size of soil A. In contrast, likelihood computes the proportion of total built area that is in a given category. To calculate the likelihood of built in soil A, you use the equation size of intersection of soil A and built divided by size of built. These ratios are frequently used to make maps to predict where change will occur. It is not immediately clear which method would be more appropriate for prediction. To clarify some of the differences between these two ratios, we will compute the probability and likelihood for two soil types. Here we see two maps of the same study area. The map on the left shows 30% built versus 70% non-built. The map on the right shows 50% soil type A and 50% soil type B. To compute the probability that soil A is built, the denominator is the total area occupied by soil A. By overlapping the maps, we can determine what proportion of soil A has been built on. The numerator is the intersection of built and soil A. The resulting ratio is 0.3, which is the probability that soil A has been built on. In calculating the probability of soil B, the denominator is the size of soil B, and the numerator is the intersection of soil B and built. Again, the resulting probability is 0.3. This indicates that 30% of soil B is built. In the case of likelihood, the denominator is the size of built rather than a soil type. In calculating the likelihood of built on soil A, the numerator is the intersection of built and the soil of interest. The likelihood that built is soil A is 0.5 because 50% of the built land is on soil A. For soil B, the numerator is the intersection of soil B and built. The likelihood that built is soil B is 0.5. Now let's look at an example in which there is more of soil B than soil A. In determining the probability that soil A is built, you will notice that the numerator and denominator are both smaller than in example 1. The resulting probability is 0.3 because 30% of soil A is built. We repeat the process when calculating the probability that soil B is built. The numerator and denominator are both larger than in example 1. The resulting probability is again 0.3 because 30% of soil B is built. Now let's calculate the likelihood that built is soil A. In this example 2, the denominator is the same as it was for example 1 because the built area is the same in examples 1 and 2. Again, the numerator is the intersection of soil A and built. The likelihood that built is soil A is 0.3 because 30% of the built land is on soil A. For likelihood that built is soil B, the denominator is the size of built while the numerator is the intersection of soil B and built. The likelihood that built is soil B is 0.7 because 70% of the built land is on soil B. One distinguishing feature between probability and likelihood is that the probabilities do not necessarily add to 1 across the categories of the explanatory variable, while the likelihoods always add to 1. Probability is the proportion of a category that is built, while likelihood is the proportion of built that is in a given category. Now we will show you an example of probability and likelihood using the GIS software TerrSet. Both examples use data from the Plum Island Ecosystems site in northeastern Massachusetts, which is funded by the National Science Foundation. The map in the upper left corner shows built in yellow and non-built in red. The map in the lower left shows 5 geology categories. The map on the right shows the empirical probability for each of the 5 geology types. The empirical probability for each category is the proportion of a geology category that is built. The highest probability is 0.49 for sand and gravel, which is represented by the darkest red, while the lowest probability is 0.14 for floodplain alluvium, which is represented by blue. In other words, 49% of sand and gravel is built, and 14% of floodplain alluvium is built. We use the same input maps to compute the likelihood of built on each geology category. The highest likelihood of built is 0.45 for till and bedrock, represented by a dark red, while the lowest likelihood for built is 0.05 for fine-grained deposit, represented by the darkest blue. In other words, 45% of built is on till and bedrock, and 5% of built is on fine-grained deposit. Compare these probability and likelihood maps. Probability and likelihood are fundamentally different. One of the most obvious differences is that probability map's yellow values in the northeast appear as blue in the likelihood map. These values represent the probability and likelihood for the fine-grained deposit category. This category has the greatest difference between probability and likelihood, which we'll explain in the next slides. This figure shows a comparison of built and non-built areas of each category of geology. Orange is built and blue is non-built. The numbers directly to the right of the orange bars show each geology type's probability. Consider the bar for fine-grained deposit. 25% of fine-grained deposit is built. The probability for each category is the length of the orange segment of the bar divided by the total length of the bar. This figure uses the same data, but the numbers directly to the right of the orange bar show built's likelihood for each geology type. The likelihood of built for each category is the length of the orange segment of the bar divided by the sum of the lengths of all the orange segments. The likelihood of built on fine-grained deposit is 5%. This figure compares the likelihoods and probabilities for various categories of geology. Blue represents probability and orange represents likelihood. Consider fine-grained deposit. The probability is the proportion of total fine-grained deposit that is built. The likelihood is the proportion of total built that is on fine-grained deposit. For more information, email us or our academic supervisors at these addresses. If you are interested in learning more about Clark Labs, Adrisi, TerrSet software, visit clarklabs.org. Also, see the two videos concerning the land change model GeoMod, which uses empirical probabilities to simulate land change. Thank you for watching.